I was poor and unhappy for 34 long years. Can you imagine being poor and unhappy for 34 long years? Well, I was. But one day, I did something about it. I got used to it. And ever since then, it's not been all that bad. Now, there has been one thing that I've had a hard time getting used to. It involves a thing called stress. Stress would not have been all that bad if it had crept upon me a little at a time. But that is not the way it happened. Let me tell you the story that I call stress. I really was born in a place called Pot Liquor, Tennessee. In the late 1940s, it was the poorest neighborhood in Johnson City, Tennessee. It was a place where there was no stress. This must have been a benefit of being poor. For you see, no one had to worry about anything being stolen. For you see, the folks in Pot Liquor were so poor that all the thieves and robbers were unemployed. About all the families qualified for help from the government. They about all received an SSI check, a sorry situation income check. It wasn't even hard to keep up with the Joneses in Pot Liquor, for you see, they weren't going anywhere either. This stress-free environment also included going to Henry Johnson School with all of the other Pot Liquor kids who kept the grading curve within the grasp of all. So there wasn't even any stress at school. But then came the time when they built a road through Pot Liquor, and our family moved to Central Community, over in Carter County near Elizabethton, where I discovered that there was no stress there either, because all of the kids attended Happy Valley School. Why, every time I would be even slightly stressed, I would just think of the name of my school, Happy Valley, and I'd feel better. I even like the sound of it today. Happy Valley even let me out of class early on Wednesdays so that I could go caddy at the Elizabethan golf course. As years went on, I had saved enough money from caddying at the Elizabethan golf course to buy myself a car. I began to get stressful over having to take a driver's test. I thought, well, why not go back to Pot Liquor and take the driver's test? And that is exactly what I did. I passed the exam that day. I still remember one question. It had a picture of a stop sign, and it provided several answers to choose from. The first one said, "This is a stop sign." Well, I liked that answer, but I thought I better check the other answers out. I looked at the second one, and it said, "This is not a stop sign." Well, I thought, this is going to be tricky. But I looked at the third choice. I knew right then that that was the one for me. It said, "I reckon this is a stop sign." I selected that one and passed without any stress. There was one additional answer on that test that I believe they would have given me some credit for. It said, "I do not know if this is a stop sign." I kind of figured that if a person didn't know, they'd probably stop and ask someone. So they'd probably give you some credit for that. Still, there was no stress in my life. But after I got that car with my driver's license, I began to date different girls. Suddenly, I began to feel some stress. It seemed like all of them wanted me to be like someone else. So one day I thought, well, why don't I just find myself a wife? Well, why not go to Potlicker and find one? And that is exactly what I did. I saw Gaylene. Gosh, it was love at first hindsight. I asked her if she'd marry me, and she said she reckoned she would. I was amazed because we had absolutely nothing in common. She had nothing, and I had nothing. And we still have some of that nothing today. We began the journey of making a perfect marriage. We did real well, and I believe I know why. You see, she didn't expect much out of me, and I've never disappointed her. But Gaylene was the cause for my stressful condition. We had been married for about 3 years, when one day my wife began rubbing her tummy, and she said, "I think I'm pregnant." Well, I told her, "Well, go to the doctor, dear." But she replied, "You know that I work third shift at Lofton Hospital, and I'm too tired to go to the doctor during the day." This scene repeated itself several times during the next 2 months. Finally came the day I'll never forget. I came home from the factory. I worked in a zinc factory probably over 15 hours that day. Came home and just collapsed across the bed. See, Gaylene was at work, and I was totally unaware that she had taken a pregnancy test at 1 a.m. at the hospital, and they called her to tell her she was definitely pregnant. She wanted to call home immediately, but she knew how tired I was. So she waited and waited, but at 3 a.m. she could wait no longer. She called home. Ringy-dingy-dingy. Ringy-dingy-dingy. Out of my deep sleep, I finally answered the phone. "Hello?" Then I heard, "I'm pregnant! I'm pregnant! I'm pregnant!" And then I replied, "Who is this?" Now that is how stress entered into my life. It's now been well over 25 years since stress suddenly came into my life. But the good news is, I have discovered 2 ways to cope with it. Now, I do believe that a husband should stand up and say exactly what needs to be said. But in order to cope, I've decided that from now on, I'm going to stand up and come right out and say exactly what my wife tells me to think. The other way that I'm handling it is that I've discovered that it helps to talk about it. And I'd like to thank you for listening and helping me overcome stress.